Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Neo Marketing Podcast. Today, we're going to talk about the mistake of starting with tactics.
Welcome to the weekly Neo Marketing Podcast, featuring one half of the Golden Goop C-Suite, Kyle Golden, and Pritch Pritchard, APR, PRSA Fellow.
Hey, Pritch, how are you doing today?
Well, a throwback to Budweiser's new ad. What's that?
The new ad, that's an old ad. That's it came right. Back via the Burger King.
Retro.
Interesting collaboration, right?
Absolutely.
Ironically, they were going back and forth on Twitter last week with the what's up. No one understood why Burger King and Budweiser was doing it, and now the ad is out.
Yeah, there you go.
So last time we talked on the Neo Marketing Podcast, we talked about strategy, about the big idea of strategy.
Right.
And that how a lot of people don't understand what it really means.
Right. Why it's so hard to figure out.
Right. I'm going to take that argument. I'm going to go a little bit deeper. I'm going to tell people the first, worst, biggest mistake you're all making if you're running a business, nonprofit, or anything else is trying to go straight to tactics.
Yes.
It's a failure. You have to start with your strategy. But much like we said last week, people don't understand strategy. They also don't understand why. What I mean when I say don't start with tactics. So I'm going to explain it, okay?
Excellent.
Tactics are the execution. Tactics are how things get done. When you write down, we're going to make a Facebook post, or we're going to use a Twitter campaign, or run ads in the newspaper, that is creating the tactic. The tactic comes from objectives. Objectives are groups of goals and ideas of what you're trying to do in a tangible, measurable way.
Yes.
And those come from the strategy, where the business is going, and what you're trying to do in a big picture way, which is what we talked about last week, right?
Correct.
So here's the failure. Business folks, please pay attention to me because I'm going to save you a lot of time and money and heartache, okay? Everyone wants to go straight to tactics. Because it seems like it's the I'm doing something.
I'm doing something.
Action,
you're moving.
Right. So strategy is a lot of conceptual talk, a little bit of research, a little bit of putting all your data in one place, a lot of writing, and a lot of planning. Right?
A lot of questions.
Yes. It's a lot of effort, and it's not something where people say, how do I sell a new widget today? How many widgets did I sell today when I had to take a whole day to talk about strategy? But without strategy, you can't set objectives. Those objectives aren't just selling widgets today,
right?
But how many you can sell over the year or over the quarter, how you compete with your competition, how you're going to position yourself in the market and achieve these things in measurable ways.
And build relationships with those who care about your company or your product.
Because you're thinking in long term.
Exactly.
As opposed to daily. Now, when you get into daily, weekly, quarterly actions, that is where the tactics come in. But too many people get straight to just do something.
Well, it's the fun stuff too, right? I mean, who wants to sit down with a pad of paper and, well, boy, that shows my age.
or an iPad,
right? I still have to write it down.
I do sometimes. Yes, so people are busy in order to be busy. And no one ever said you get great ROI out of being busy.
Right.
What you want is to be effective, productive, and efficient. Efficiency and effectiveness comes from tactics that are on target. For the objectives created from your strategy.
Exactly.
So how do you figure out ROI, right? The cost of something versus how much money you can make off of it. Profitability creates ROI, return on investment. And ROI isn't always dollars and cents. It can be effort and attention as well.
Right.
Human capital is part of the ROI equation.
Right.
Too many people say, hey, social media is free. Sure, unless you figure out how much time it took you to
right.
do it and how much you pay yourself or pay that employee per hour. Now there's a cost associated, right? Now there's a cost associated, you better have an ROI. So don't be making social media posts simply because they have to be doing something. You have to be working towards the process of conversion. Just the only metrics that means anything in business is gaining attention and then converting that attention into an action that creates economic value, thus ROI. If they don't buy something, if they don't attend the thing, if they don't do the action we want from them, then there's no return on our investment because we're not converting. You are not going to convert people through tactics accidentally.
Right.
You know, 1% of the time, 2% of the time you can. You know, hey, we put a tweet out about our event and some people showed up. But two people showed up instead of the 2,000 you needed. That comes from planning, strategy, execution, measurement, adaptation, et cetera, right? The whole process. And your tactics aren't part of that process if you start there. You have to end there.
Right.
The other thing too is, of course, everyone says, hey Kyle, hey Pritch, I've got a business. What should I do for more sales?
Right. Well, you're asking the wrong question.
You're starting in the wrong place.
Right.
Of course you want more sales. Of course you want better attendance to your events. Of course you want people to donate to your nonprofit. Of course you want these things. The question is, why does it exist? Why does it exist? Who's my audience? What's my position in the industry, et cetera? And then you can get into how do I do that? It's very hard for me to right off the cuff at a networking event to say, oh, your business should be on social media. Your business should be using traditional. Your business should be creating podcasts. I don't know what your tactics are because I don't know the answers to the other big questions.
Right. And it wouldn't matter if I knew what your tactics were because I'm just guessing. I don't understand your strategy.
Right. So I'm telling you now, it's hard to come up with a tactic that's actually going to work. Here's the key phrase. That's actually going to work. Straight from what do I need to do for my business? Now, if you'll back up, you'll do the strategy, then you get into down the process, your objectives, your measurements, etc. When it comes to talk tactics, it's simple. They present themselves.
They just fall out.
It's very obvious what your tactic will be if you understand who you are, what your business or nonprofit is, your position versus your competition, what your competition's strengths and weaknesses are, how you compete with them, how you're different, differentiation, another great word, one of my favorites,
absolutely.
Right? How you set yourself apart, not being better, being different, setting yourself apart, then figure out who your audience is.
Understanding the audience.
What motivates them, what's most likely, because you do this in a cycle and you make adjustments, what's most likely to create conversion.
Right.
The thing that works most, you do more of. The things that do least, you do less of.
Right.
And the things that are working okay, you just adapt how you're doing them. Again, these are all the tactics. But it's super easy to answer these questions if you understand all of the rest of it and you're not simply guessing.
If you're working from a foundation of stone and not sand, right?
Folks, here it is. Don't start with tactics. Finish with tactics. But remember, it's a never-ending cycle, so the measurement of those tactics will go back to the strategy. Start with strategy. Don't start with tactics. Start in the right place. Go through the process. Adapt and change. And even though it seems like that big first planning session isn't selling any widgets today,
right?
Ultimately, you'll sell much, 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 much more of your widget, of your thing, of whatever, if you do it right with tactics that make sense, based on your strategy and execution on your audience.
Bam, there it is.
Ends up with conversion. Conversion creates ROI. The whole point of business is ROI because you got to be profitable or you're not a business, not for long.
There you go.
Simple, folks. Don't start with tactics. Start with strategy. End with tactics. Measure and go back again. Till next time, good luck.
Ciao.